Alrighty, welcome to the first Eldritch Moon Draft here for ChannelFireball.com. I've got a pretty good pack here. Permeating Nass, as I like to call it, is not the card I'm going to be first picking. This card is pretty neat, though. Clear Shot is a clear first pick. This card is one of the best, if not the best, uncommons. It's in a good color. Green's very good. And it just goes in any deck. You can set up a very good combat with this. And even outside of combat, you can just pick off a creature. I do like Vexing Scuttler a lot. I like the Emerge cards a fair amount. So Scuttler is probably my second favorite card out of this pack. You want this often in blue-red, but even in blue-green, it's still easy to figure out good targets like Clear Shot. Weaver of Lightning's not bad, though I would probably take Vilden Pack Outcast over the Weaver of Lightning. And that about ends the... and Brazen Wolf. Brazen Wolf's also, I think, better than Weaver of Lightning. Pick one. But either way, we're taking Clear Shot and going from there. You want to see a weird card? Mournwillow. Mournwillow is a weird card. Yep. It is truly bizarre, and I don't think there's a good black-green aggro deck or a black-green delirium deck. The black-green delirium deck is okay, but the aggro deck not so much. So we will not be taking Mournwillow. There's Prey Upon. It's a solid pick. It's not insane. Prey Upon is less good than it has been. There is Subjugator Angel, which is a fine card too. I think also not quite as good as where most people have her, but you know she's very good. If you knew she was going to be your 13th card down every game, you'd probably take her, but sometimes you draw her in the wrong situation. It's also Vilden Pack Outcast, a card I'm very high on, and Brazen Wolves, plus Weaver of Lightning, I guess. Gonna be lots of Wolves and Weavers. So, really comes down to what I want to take Prey Upon, stay green, though I think it's worse than Subjugator Angel, Brazen Wolves, and Outcast, so probably not. I think second pick, you probably shouldn't be doing that. Could take Subjugator. I like red-green more than white-green, but Subjugator may be better than these other cards. I'm just going to take Vilden Pack Outcast. I think this card is awesome. Well, there's a Lashweed Lurker, third pick, and I love Lashweed Lurker. This card is highly splashable, very, very good in blue-green, and you can cast for 8 if you need to, alongside Grizzled Angler, Scour the Laboratory, Bloodbriar, another one of my favorites. So, a lot of blue cards. Also, Spreading Flames, a card I've been a little less impressed with. Whereas Lashweed Lurker is great in this format because you can put an expensive card back, Spreading Flames is actually kind of bad because it's going to kill one, maybe two creatures. So, I'm going to take Lashweed Lurker. I've never passed this card a day in my life. Also, there's a Wretched Griff here, so let's lean towards blue-green. Look, I swear I'm not forcing blue-green, but I think Wretched Griff is significantly better than Alchemist Greeting, and Lashweed Lurker 3rd is a real thing. Also, It of the Horrid Swarm, Lab Brute, Graph Rats, which is the card you want after you have Midnight Scavengers and not before. All right, Wretched Griff it is. And I think this is a pretty solid start, even with the second pick, Vilden Pack Outcast, which I'm hopefully not playing. This is kind of where, not only where I want to be, but these cards are very good. Oh, wow. Fifth pick, Noose Constrictor and Bloodbriar and Backwood Survivalist and Spontaneous Mutation, which not a card I think is great in blue-green, but still just a pretty good card. I'm going to take the Noose Constrictor, though. The Noose is loose. This card is very good. Green is very open, so I'm glad I'm in green. And hopefully I can wheel some of these Bloodbriars. I would not mind that at all. All right, Foul Emissary, a card I do like. Ubenwald Captive, so yeah, green wide open. Vexing Scuttler is pretty late too, though. Given I already have two Emerge cards, I'm just going to take Foul Emissary. It's great in blue-green. It's great with these two Emerge cards. You want fodder to sacrifice. It's going to be better than Captive with these two cards, so Foul Emissary that is. And then this pack, of course, very disappointing. There's just no playables here, but that's all right. I will probably take... I guess I could take Waxing Moon as the only green card. I'm not going to play Nymphalia Academy. There's Crossroads Consecrator too. Yeah, whatever. I'm not playing any cards there. And that's a Lashweed Lurker. All right, well, this is a good draft. I will take Lashweed Lurker. Is that an 8th pick Lashweed Lurker? Yep, sure is. All right. probably just take Convolute now. Not going to play any of these other cards. Convolute's a playable card. Not a card I tend to want to main deck, but certainly playable. I'm really glad I took Foul Emissary, given that I picked up the second Lashweed Lurker. This deck's setting up to be insane. It's actually so much green and blue that the person to my left or the people to my left might be in it, so Pack 2 might not be good. Pack 3, I assume, is going to be quite strong. And really, there's not that much that I'm missing. I mean, I at this point, I would love to pick up Primal Druid or Exultant Cultist, but I'm in really good shape. The fact that I've got double Lurker or Clear Shot means I just have good interaction. Foul Emissary and Noose Constrictor is great cards. I mean, look, I have 5 premium uncommons and a Wretched Griff is my deck so far. So, yeah, this is the place to be. Alright, well, I really don't need a third convolute, so I'll take a sideboard Spring Sage Ritual, and I guess I'll take a Field Creeper, which I hope I don't have to play. I'm gonna take the Swamp passing black and red, and then take Wolfkin Bond, which no chance I play it. I wanted to pass the black and red cards so that the person to my left takes it, or the people to my left take them, and see them as a signal, even though those cards are bad, just that someone took a basic land over them. But Wolfkin Bond I'll take for the opposite reason. I'm not gonna play it, but I don't want to pass a last pick Wolfkin Bond for no particular reason. And here we go, Plains. Alright. Let's first pick an Igenious Scob, I guess. I mean, there's also an Exultant Cultist. This deck may actually want Cultist. I haven't almost never made that pick before. I do think Stitcher's Graft is a pretty good card. This lets you throw your creatures at your opponent for lots of damage, even though you eventually lose them or have to wait for them to untap. But it's not great in a deck that's just full of gigantic emerge creatures. Like, these creatures stand on their own for the most part. I mean, I might play it still, but I'm not going to take it over Scob or Cultist. I only have one spell so far, and blue-green tends to not be particularly spell-heavy. I also have three emerge creatures. I think this deck might want... No, I'm just going to take the Scob still. Look, Cultist is great. I really want to pick up Cultist, Enlightened Maniac, Primal Druid to sacrifice to my emerge creatures, but Ingenious Scob is just too good, so I'll take that. And Eternal Scourge. It is, the picture is exiled for now. I'll just take another Wretched Griff passing on Exultant Cultist. This is getting a little greedy, but... It's getting a little greedy there. That's the end of the sentence, I guess. Ooh, and paid off, because now I get to take an Exultant Cultist and have the Wretched Griff. So the reason I did that last pick, despite it being greedy, is because Wretched Griff is such a more powerful card than Cultist. Cultist is a lot more replaceable. And, you know, like those cards I named, like the Primal Druid and Enlightened Maniac, also in Innistrad, or Shadows of Innistrad, rather, you have cards like Brunau Corpse Trawler and... even like Stoic Builder cards that give you a little bit of value and you can sacrifice. Whereas Griff has no replacement other than other emerge creatures. And having like 4 to 5 emerge creatures is kind of perfect. So happy with that pick. Happy I'm getting past a Cultist. Someone's getting a late Thalia's Lancers. Human Knight, huh? So they are humans after all. Another Cultist here. Things are going great. I'm just going to play all Exultant Cultists, Wretched Griffs, and Lashweed Lurkers. I'm just going to win all my games really easily. And here we've got, well, another Ingenious Scob, which I'll take, because this is definitely not a Curious Homunculus deck. And even though I don't have very many spells, Scob is still good. Better than Swift Spinner and Turn Aside. So I'll take Scob, and I mean, who knows? I'll pick up maybe a spell or two here and there. Could take Laboratory Brute, but I don't really have particular combos with it. I might just take Fortune's Favor. It's an instant for my Scobs, and it's just a playable card. So Fortune's Favor it up. And this pack... nothing for me. I could Displace, but it's not really a combo with these. These are all on cast, so don't actually have any combos with Displace except Foul Emissary. I'm not going to play another Wolfkin Bond, and I'm not going to hate draft a Ride Down or anything like that, so let's just take Displace here. And grab a Crop Sigil. Crop Sigil is a playable card. Probably not going to play it in this deck, but because it's not going to get Delirium very easily. But it is good. Maybe I might end up. It triggers the Scobs at least. Contingency plan pretty bad. Take inventory pretty bad. All right, I'll take the ride down now. No more riding down. So I picked up 2 Exultant Cultists and a Foul Emissary as things to sacrifice, which isn't bad. I would have loved a Primal Druid, but this is okay. And I'm gonna have. I guess I'm gonna be a little light on playables going into Pack 3 because I think Pack 2 was soft for the reasons I said before. I just passed so much of this deck. But I feel like Pack 3 is gonna be good. And if I have to play like. I don't know, random card or two, then I'm not super worried. Like, Convolute is a playable card. Really don't want Wolfkin Bond in this deck, or Field Creeper. I could play Field Creeper if I have a little bit more Delirium. Who knows? See, look, like Laboratory Brute. It is a playable card, so we'll end up fine. And grab another Displace. Well, it's places in the sideboard. Turn Aside's a great sideboard card. I like having one Turn Aside just to sideboard in, though I tend not to main deck it. All right, now there's no real reason. The person to my right is just going to be whatever colors they are. They should be set already, so passing a Prophetic Ravings, there's just no reason to. Okay, well, Rabid Bite, that's a card. It's great with Ingenious Scob. Decent with these, good with these. It's better than Graph Mole, Broken Concentration, Confront the Unknown. So I will Rabid Bite it up, and... second pick, a lot less exciting. I could take Veteran Cathar because it's a 2-drop. I really don't anticipate splashing. I didn't even pick up any Terrarians. I could take Aim High, which is good with Ingenious Scob. I don't generally like combat tricks in the Emerge decks because your big creatures are so big. But Veteran Cathar is so medium, and I'm not going to play Catalog, so I actually will just take the Aim High. I got to make my Ingenious Scobs you know, just a little bit better, right? And plus, I might be getting towards a crop sigil in the deck if I have, you know, so a mix of instants and sorceries, creatures, lands, and enchantments. And this pack's a little better. Like Stitchwing Scob, unfortunately, Epitaph Golem, RIP. I have to write an epitaph for it, I guess. It's the self-mill deck is not really a thing anymore. Stitchwing Scob shores up the 4-drop. You can sack it to emerge and then eventually get it back. I think it's better than Jace's Scrutiny, especially since I just took a combat trick. Ooh, Epiphany of the Drainer and Obsessive Skinner. Wow. Okay, this is an interesting pick. I like Epiphany. I think this card's pretty powerful, but with double Cultist, double Retrogriff, I'm already drawing a lot of cards. This is a 2-drop, and I've got a minor Delirium theme. Yeah, this, I think Skinner's going to be much better than Epiphany, and even Stormrider Spirit, which is another card I don't mind playing. Now I have to decide whether I have enough playables. I have 17, because I really want to take Woodland Stream. This is the card I would normally pick here. I don't have enough self-mill for Stoic Builder, really. I just have the Brute, and I guess this, at this point the Crop Sigil is likely to get in. Stormrider Spirit is a fine card, too. This format's a little slower. I'm just going to take Stormrider Spirit. I think the Spirit does get in there. Could take Fork in the Road now. One reason to do that is it does enable Delirium. It's a sorcery and a land in the graveyard, and I have only one sorcery so far. I've got two Delirium cards, and they're both pretty good. So, all right, I'll take Fork in the Road. I don't like Hinterland Logger. I would love to pick up a Jace's Ingenuity at some point, but I don't think that's going to happen. Probably take Briarbridge Patrol here. Provisioner's not bad. I mean, the Cultists are humans. Phalanxer's a human. Skinner's a human. But Briarbridge, I think, is just higher upside. And it's a little bit slower. Ooh, Wildfield Scarecrow. This one's nice. I think better than Thornhide Wolves. All right, and we've gotten there, by the way. This is already 22. And I would like to pick up one or two more playables, but I think I'll be fine either way. All right. Well, Lamplighter's a playable card, and I've even got a couple zombies, right? Just the Exalted, or the Ingenious Scobs and the Laboratory Brute, but I like Confront. I don't have any other clue cards besides Briarbridge, but still, Confront's a good card. So, take Confront. I just hate a Bold Arm Duelist at this point. I would like to play 17 lands plus the Fork in the Road here. This deck's gonna, it's got a lot of mana between, like, Fortune's Favor, maybe Crop Sigil, Wildfield Scarecrow, but all that's fine. Magmatic Chasm actually a kind of annoying card to play against these days. It just turns out that Magmatic Chasm is better when the games go longer, though this deck I don't think particularly cares about it. Confront also great with Ingenious Scob, by the way. So I wavered for a second on Scob versus Cultist. Very glad I took Scob. Ends up I have like four good instants to go with it, and Rabid Bite's just a good combo with it too. So Scob's gonna be good. I think this deck is just fantastic. Yeah, I mean, I would love to cut Lab Brute, but it does enable my two Delirium cards. Every other card in the deck is just good. I mean, Stormrider is one of my worst cards, and I guess Fork in the Road is not fantastic, but for the most part, this deck is just all good cards. All right, I'll take Stoic Builder. I could run the Builder, but I think I'll put Bob in the sideboard for now. I guess I could take out Fork in the Road and play Stoic Builder instead, but I like having the one sorcery. Stoic Builder and Noose Constrictor just go off. No, that's not. It's not a recommended combo. And Island. All right, let's get this going. Because we built our deck during the draft, we're actually done. I mean, I don't think there's much to think about here. Fork in the Road is probably like the worst card, but again, getting Delirium on Skinner is very good. And getting value off Crop Sigil is good too. Being able to return like a Lashweed Lurker or a Retrogriff is optimal. I like Fortune's Favor, I like the combat tricks. 16 creatures is kind of perfect. The only card I could see playing are like a Stoic Builder and maybe a Wolfkin Bond, but I don't like Wolfkin Bond in this deck. Yeah, I'd rather not have to play Convolute. Yeah, this is good. 8-9. Could actually play one more Forest because Fork in the Road counts as an island, so I end up with like 10 green sources and 8 blue sources. And all my green cards are, my cheap cards are green. Yeah, I don't know. I don't have double blue in any color either, so there we go.